Hi, this is Ryan Turner, Artistic Director of Emmanuel Music, and I'm here with soprano, oboist, and composer Theodosia Roussos. Welcome, Theodosia. It's so great to see you. Theodosia was in the Bach Institute in January of 2015, and now she's in her hometown of LA, and her career has gone in so many different directions. Tell us a little bit more about what you've been up to.
Well, before the pandemic, I was recently in the opera Sweetland with the industry and also freelancing as an oboe player. I was fortunate I got to have a LA Phil recently. And then I am also writing an opera. and recently got hired to co-write a documentary for Netflix. It's been very busy and eclectic.
That's good. It's interesting you say eclectic. I was reading up on everything you've been doing in your career. I mean, you've really expanded numerous genres. I see you've worked with a number of sort of contemporary popular artists. You sang the role of Maria in West Side Story. You've sung Bach. You're writing an opera yourself. What is it like working in these multiple genres, one part and the other? How do you handle this sort of trifurcated career and handling the balance of all these different activities? I can only imagine what your organization of your life must be like.
Well, let me just start by saying organization's not my strong suit, so I have to write everything down. But I will say it's so fun. I just feel really, really lucky because all of these different things I do are different parts of myself that I love to explore. And I really feel like if I wasn't able to do all these different things, I wouldn't feel like I was able to be satisfied, you know, because I just started composing just because I love to be creative. And I've written a really long time. I just hadn't shared my music with anyone. And actually the piece you're gonna hear, Polymnia, was something I was writing just to get in touch with my family history. Polymnia was my great grandmother and I found her poetry. And I wasn't planning to share it with anyone. I was just sort of writing it. I really hadn't thought anyone would want to hear it, to be totally honest. I'm like my own worst thing. But I played them one day for my voice teacher at USC and she was like in tears. And I was like, oh, maybe people do want to hear these. So I ended up like workshopping them at Banff and also with John Harbison. Songfest. I performed it at Songfest too. And also with Jake Hagee, and they both gave me, and Libby Larson, they gave me wonderful comments. And it was so wonderful to see John again after the Bach Institute. It just like feels like family, you know?
Mm. That's a great segue to a question I have about your time at the Bach Institute. You know, it's, I'm sure, just a blip on the radar screen in the three short weeks, rather intense weeks that you were with us. But can you tell us a little bit about how that experience has filtered into the rest of your musical life moving forward?
Absolutely. I mean, every time I play Bach, I think of Peggy Pearson.
I think we all do.
I know. And I also think of Kendra. I think of, Kendra coached me on so many things. And I think of how Peggy taught me about inflection. And she taught me about even the sound, the kind of reed that you need when you play Bach. And I think of the heavy reed that I brought on the first day and she was like, this is not gonna work. In her like very blunt way. And I was like,
that's right.
So that was funny. And then, and with Kendra, I mean, Kendra coached me on one of the most famous Bach arias for oboe that's on a lot of auditions, which is cantata 84. And all of those times really have stayed with me. I mean, not just when I'm playing Bach. And I think that time was so special because I also like made wonderful friends at the Bach Institute. And now I like Cecilia Belling, I visited her in Denmark. Mm-hmm. And Magda Kuzma is like doing so well as an opera singer now. And she was a freshman when we were there together. And I remember thinking like, wow, she's such a stunning singer. And we went on to collaborate with more Bach at Oberlin, and all of the coaches. I mean, you working with you was incredible, and I really felt like a family to me, that whole experience.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned John Harbison, which you know, this is also a good sort of transition into talking about your opera. I've always felt in John's music that you can find Bach in almost everything he does, and it's sometimes not even intentional. It's just part of his DNA. And in listening to this little excerpt that you're going to play us, I definitely heard some strands of Bach finding their way into your composition. You started to talk a little bit about it, but can you tell us a little bit more about this opera and set up the excerpt that you're sharing with us?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think also just on that topic, one of the ways I think of Bach in terms of my own compositions are I think of the drama of those lines. I think at Bach Institute, I studied Cantata 115, which has that beautiful Obo d'Amore solo. Mm-hmm. And that was so like heart-wrenching. And I worked so much on that with you guys, and it was really incredible. And I will never forget any note of that piece, you know? And I do think that enters into your musical DNA. It's sort of part of your body after that. And writing this opera, I mean, a lot of what goes into it is also my family heritage and the Greek folk music that I grew up with. My uncles were musicians. They had like 20 folk albums that they put out into the world. And so whenever I'd go to New York, and they lived in Astoria, one of them, and that's where my family originally came when they came to this country. And I would grow up singing Christmas carols in Greek and like folk songs. And then there's all these Byzantine chants. My great-grandmother's, or I guess my great-grandfather was a cantor in the Greek church. He was like the first cantor at St. Dimitrios in Astoria. And then before that, there's like all these cantors in my family. So there's all these singers. So I do feel this sort of legacy that I'm composing. I think there have been a lot of very creative artists and musicians in my family that just haven't had the chance to dedicate their lives to it, you know? And so I feel really lucky to be able to do this. I mean, and it's this the story that is being told that I'm telling in the opera is how my great-grandmother survived the Greek genocide, which happened around World War I. And it happened at the same time as the Armenian genocide. So, I mean, there were 1.5 million Greeks killed, 1.5 million Armenians, and nobody really knows about it. It's not acknowledged by the present Turkish government. This happened during the Ottoman Empire by the Young Turks. But it's interesting because a lot of these atrocities are still happening. And I never really intended to make a political opera, but it is inherently political. You know, it's about the survival of people that were not supposed to live, you know? And my great-grandmother never spoke about this. So finding these letters these poems was really interesting, because if you met her, she was just the happiest person. And she loved her children. She loved her grandchildren. She was obsessed with feeding people. And
of course.
So it's about her survival and how she thrived, like despite holding all of this inside of her.
Well, that's amazing that you're giving voice to her story through your music and Bach's influence on your music, and combining that with, as you say, these Byzantine era chants and your family's history in the church as cantors. I found it to be a very moving and stunning excerpt. So thank you, Theodosia. It's great to catch up with you and hear everything that's happening in your career. And we're going to say farewell and leave our audience with this little clip from your opera, Polymnia.
Thank you so much, Ryan. Great to see you.
Thank you, and best wishes to you.
Thank you.
Good evening, and welcome to the Bach Institute Alumni Concert. My name is Ryan Turner. I'm the Artistic Director of Emmanuel Music. While we don't have our normal group of students here, we are thrilled to invite back some of our notable alumni for an evening of arias, duets, and ensembles. This evening's concert is constructed by my co-director, Pamela Dalal, as pieces from all the second Jahrgang of Bach, or his second year in Leipzig, where he was writing only chorale cantatas. Pam has shaped an evening that is in two sets that take the arc or the journey of what one would normally hear in a cantata, although taken from disparate movements, all from the second Jahrgang. I'm thrilled that we have these alumni here, and unfortunately, our tenor Daniel McGrew is not able to be with us this evening, and I'm grateful to my colleague and fellow faculty member Frank Kelly, and along with myself, we will cover the tenor duties and we'll be thinking of you, Daniel. We're sorry not to have you with us. We hope you enjoy this evening's concert, and please join us tomorrow morning for a live rehearsal and lecture by our principal guest conductor, John Harbison, on cantata BWV 32. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy this concert. school.